Carla requested that we create a 20-ounce tumbler cup mock-up on Photopea. On this video, we're doing that. Even when somebody is holding the cup and we're going to place their logo behind their fingers, join me, let's do that. A new project on Photopea. You can use any size that you like, and I always like working on a transparent background. So let's call this Carla's. And we're gonna create. After opening your canvas, grab the image that you want to use as your mockup. Then we go and grab the logo that we want to place on our 20-ounce cup. And once it's added, using your move tool, move the logo over to the cup. And at the moment, it's straight on and the cup is skewed. So we're gonna switch on the transform control. And then we move our mouse so that we see the back-to-back arrows that show, so that we are able to rotate the image. Once you've rotated the image exactly the way that you want, then you're going to right-click and you're going to select warp. And with your warp, there are different styles of warps that you can use with all of your designs. Photopea and Photoshop have different warps. So if you select on style, you get different kinds of warps depending on the kind of photo you are busy manipulating. So if we have currently a 20-ounce cup that is slender at the bottom and larger at top, that would normally be an arc lower that you would use. So you would click on arc lower and then it would show you how it's going to look like. You can then start manipulating it and fitting it on there. But what I do want to show you is that it has different kinds. The most popular one is the cylinder one. So if you have a normal cup, straight cylinder, you would use the cylinder cup because it's normal, it's straight, and then you would manipulate it to the way that you want.
Warp speed.
For now, we are using the arc lower. Then you warp the design to the cylinder nicely like that. And when you're happy with the way it looks, you're going to select correct. We can switch off the controls and it looks like that. Once you're done with your design, you can go back to the layer section and you can start making different colors on the design so that it suits what you're designing. So if we darken it, it just blends it quite nicely in there and it looks like a one design and it's not like manipulated. You can also use multiply. So it depends on how it looks to you as the subject matter expert, as a designer. So this is how it looks like. Color, I hope it adds value. And anybody else who's watching the video, let's do the second one. The second one we're doing is of somebody holding the 20-ounce cup and they have fingers on there. We're going to use the same principle of adding our logo that we've downloaded to the design. And we're going to move the logo over to the cup and we're going to size it. I'm going to use one finger as an example. However, you can use all fingers if you want. It's up to you. The next thing that you're going to do is you're going to right click on your design and you're going to rasterize it. Once it's rasterized, you're going to go to your erasers. You're going to go to this brush tool and eraser. So then you're going to select erase tool. Before you start erasing, you're just going to clip mask it and then zoom in with a command plus to see what you're doing and then delete the section that you don't want. Awesome. Now that it's cut and it's deleted, you can now transform this or warp it. Then select edit and click on transform and select warp. And with your warp, you choose the style of warp that you want. You can choose customize and customize it so that it covers that extra space that you've made or those extra cuts that you've made. And you can use lower arc, whichever one that you want. And you just adjust it ever so gently to suit the cup that you're designing. All the way until you are happy and the extra cuts that we've made are now gone. We're going to select correct because we're happy with how it looks, and we're going to go to our layers and we're going to multiply it so that it darkens it. To learn more on Photopea, we have a playlist that you can go grab a video and learn more. If this has added value, please smash the like button and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you so much for joining me today. I had so much fun, Kala. I hope this has helped. I will see you on the next video.